Oh, my gosh, it's so great to be here. I'm having a great time getting around, walking through malls, seeing a lot of the town, and lots of big, exciting events like this iPhone introduction. I'll get to be first in the world instead of last in the world this year.
What, is Brisbane the first place in the world?
Well, it's right up there with the, I don't think there's anything ahead of Brisbane for this model. And usually I'm home sitting in line on my computer at this time, noticing people unboxing and opening up their iPhones in Sydney or someplace like that. And I'm drooling, thinking, oh, my gosh, it's old news by the time it hits California. So now it's early news.
Yeah.
Steve,
yes.
What made you decide to go and line up tonight? Why do it? You could have had it 6 months ago.
I've lined up for every single iPhone and every single iPad, no matter what city I was in so far. So why would I stop? It's kind of like, I don't know, you're a Grateful Dead follower and you don't know why. You don't have a real good explanation. I have a lot of ways to get other iPhones. This iPhone is not even 100% compatible in the United States, but it's an important event for mankind. It's an important event in history, an important event for technology. And to me, it's more important than anything. I'm a gadget guy. I love my gadgets. They are my play toys. And this is the Apple phones are the highlight of them all. They're the best invention ever. It was the Apple, 4S, and today it's the Apple 5. And I just like to get them in my hands, play with them, try this, try that, add new things to them. And I don't use them as fully as some other people, especially a lot of young people, but it's a part of my life. My whole life has been hooking things up, new apps on, trying them, see how they work, And
What time did you line up?
I actually arrived here after midnight. Some people were here as early as yesterday afternoon. Usually when I'm home, I come at noon the day before. But I had restrictions because I had tickets to a great concert here in Brisbane last night. Just really, I'll never forget it. Julia Stone.
Oh, okay.
For what I like in music and concerts and performers, I got, 10 times more than I ever expected.
You better move here.
Huh?
You better move to Brisbane.
I'm not going to move to Brisbane, most likely, but I am underway to become an Australian citizen.
Oh, terrific.
That's a little known fact, but I don't like heat, I like cool, so probably Melbourne.
Steve, would you give up your American citizenship or have dual citizenship?
No, it turns out that I get to keep my American citizenship, but I intend, who knows what will follow through in the next 5 years, but I intend to call myself an Australian and feel an Australian and study the history and become, as much of a real citizen here as I can.
Well, Steve, I'll let you in on a little secret. I haven't told anyone yet in the office this morning, and it's a sad reflection on me, I know, but I actually dreamt of the iPhone 5 last night because I was so excited. Do you dream of it?
You know what? I don't. And I guess I'm so inundated with technology news all the time. I know what's coming. I know what it is. But, believe it or not, I'm going to walk in, and just like everybody else, do I want the white or do I want the black? And you can't really tell in articles on the web as well as you can in real life and when it's in your hands. So I'm going to choose my color and, pretty much that. I'm going to, I can't get a contract here without an Australian mailing address. So I'm going to get, just a full price phone and see how it goes.
Why did you fall in love with Australia, Steve?
All my life, every time I've ever come to Australian cities, many a time I've always loved it, and so has my wife. And, whether I'm in Sydney or Perth or Melbourne or Brisbane or Lightning Ridge, I have only two items on my entire bucket list for life, and I've had these two items for about a year. And one of them is to see Ayers Rock, which I will someday, and the other is to see Tasmania.
Wonderful stuff. We thank you so much for joining us. And Steve, before we let you go, is there anything special or secret that you can tell us about the next big Apple product?
Yeah, there is, but I'd have to kill you.
That could be an option. You never know.
Yes, you like pain, don't you, Mary?
No, I couldn't tell you anything, really.
Yeah, of course not.
I'm not really directly involved in that kind of the new products and what's in them, and I don't even try to ask questions and introspect, so... But I know I feel the same as you do. Let's wait and hope.